Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome. Our special guest this morning, U.S. Secretary of Labor Marty Walsh, of course, the former Boston mayor in his first Boston TV interview. Secretary Walsh, welcome.
Thank you for having me today.
Thank you for joining us. So the May job figures were released a few hours before we recorded this interview on Friday, and they show job creation doubling over the April numbers, but still falling short of some predictions. What is your takeaway from these numbers, and what can the administration do to speed up this job recovery?
Well, I think first and foremost, the job report today was a good, solid job report. It shows that we still have a way to go. Over the last 4 months, we've added about 540,000 jobs per month. It shows that President Biden's economic plan is working. We're still living in the midst of a pandemic, so we're going to continue to work to add more jobs. The biggest growth we saw this month was in hospitality and in restaurants, which is a good thing. We saw also in education. So we're going in the right direction.
Well, Republican governors in half the states in the union, 25 states, including New Hampshire, have said they intend to bring an early end to the $300 weekly unemployment supplement, along with most or all benefits for the self-employed and the long-term unemployed, as a way of persuading more people to go back to work at a time when many businesses blame those benefits for their inability to fill jobs. Is there any truth to those claims?
I would say that today's job report shows that those claims, there's not a lot of truth to those claims. One of the areas we saw the largest growth and some of the areas that we've heard, even in the city of Boston, finding a hard time finding people to work is in restaurants. We're seeing those people come back to work. I think what we're dealing with is unemployment has kept a lot of roof over people's heads and food on the table. As we continue to move forward here, as we continue to get through the recovery, more and more people will get back into the job force. All businesses aren't fully opened yet, as we all know. The restrictions in the city are going to be lifted last week. So we're going to start to see a lot more people coming back into the job force as these restrictions are lifted all across this country in different areas.
Now, one factor that might be inhibiting people from returning to the workplace that I've seen cited is safety concerns, which obviously have been a big issue throughout the pandemic. Now, OSHA, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, which you oversee as Labor Secretary, has been gutted in recent years to the point where it was unable to enforce rules about COVID-era work hazards. How bad is that situation that you inherited, and what are you doing to fix it?
Well, you know, it wasn't a good situation. OSHA is down a couple hundred people almost as far as enforcement officers out in the street through the American Rescue Plan that the president passed and signed into law right before I became the Secretary of Labor. Those investments are now in OSHA. We're hiring people right now. He also made investments, $39 billion in childcare. Many people in Boston and around this country still don't have adequate childcare, don't have good childcare to be able to send it to go back to work. So that money's being released. So we're starting to see more hiring up here in the Department of Labor and throughout government, quite honestly. Many of these areas, these are very important areas. When you think about the Department of Labor, it's OSHA, obviously, it's wage and hour, it's unemployment insurance, it's different areas that really impact people all across the country. So we're working now to make sure that we're getting the right people in the right position so we can continue the mission of the Department of Labor.
Just quickly before we take our break, and we'll go on to some other matters here, from one side of the political spectrum, you hear the argument that, well, these benefits are too lavish, people are taking the summer off, et cetera, that's why employers can't fill the jobs. From the other side, we hear the retort that, you know what, you're long overdue, a lot of you employers, to increase wages and be more competitive and as an inducement to people to come work. Do you side with that latter argument?
Well, actually, in this report, we've seen an increase in wages across the board, which is a good thing. We've seen some modest increases in wages. And I think that, you know, as we think about moving forward, we'll probably talk about it on the other side of the break. But the American Jobs Plan is really about making investments in the American workforce to create opportunities and pathways for people to get into the middle class.